In the last video, I talked about how triacylglycerols are broken down to provide fatty acids. In this video, I'll describe how fatty acids are converted to acetyl-CoA in an oxidative process that produces the reduced electron carriers NADH and QH2. Many tissues, including liver and muscle, readily take up fatty acids from the bloodstream into the cytosol. But rather than degrade fatty acids in the cytosol, it's better to produce acetyl-CoA and NADH in the mitochondrial matrix, where they can feed directly into the citric acid cycle and electron transport chain. To transport fatty acids from the cytosol into the matrix, they must first be activated by attachment to coenzyme A. This process is energetically costly, requiring hydrolysis of ATP to AMP and 2-phosphates. The resulting fatty acyl-CoA is transported into the mitochondrial matrix. Note that activation and transport of fatty acids is not part of the process of beta-oxidation, but it is required to move the fatty acid so that beta-oxidation can occur. The beta-oxidation process contains four reactions that repeat until all carbons are converted to acetyl-CoA. The diagram assumes a starting fatty acyl chain with an even number of carbon atoms, with the number represented by the letter N. In each set of four steps, four electrons are removed from carbon. Two are put onto coenzyme Q to make QH2, and two electrons are put onto NAD+ to make NADH. Also, two carbons are removed from the fatty acyl chain to produce acetyl-CoA, and we're left with a fatty acyl-CoA that is two carbons shorter than the one that we started with. That shorter acyl-CoA will undergo another round of four reactions, in which two more carbons are removed from the chain and producing QH2 and NADH. The cycle repeats until all carbons are in the form of acetyl-CoA. The number of cycles depends on the length of the original acyl chain. For example, if we start with an 8-carbon chain, then we will need 3 turns of the cycle, with the last cycle producing 2 molecules of acetyl-CoA. The net reaction for this process is shown here. If we assume a saturated acyl-CoA chain with 2N carbons, then we'll need N-1 turns of the cycle to completely convert the acyl-CoA into acetyl-CoA. We'll end up with N molecules of acetyl-CoA, which can enter the citric acid cycle. Now, liver cells can convert some of these to things called ketone bodies, which I'll describe in the next video. We'll also get N-1 molecules of NADH and QH2, which give their electrons to the electron transport chain, allowing synthesis of ATP. This equation is true for saturated fatty acyl chains with an even number of carbons. Now, we are able to oxidize fatty acyl chains with an odd number of carbons. At the end, we'll get a 3-carbon unit that is fed into the citric acid cycle a different way, and we're not going to worry about that in this course. We're also able to oxidize unsaturated fatty acyl chains, but because they are already partly oxidized, we won't get as much NADH out of this process, and it might also cost us some NADPH if that double bond is not properly positioned to allow the chemistry that needs to happen. In the next video, I'll describe the role of ketone bodies.